utilization. Okay, so here we'll go to our hardware. I took a server because I want to reduce my infrastructure. So then I virtualize this server by installing a hypervisor. Okay, so then I can create a virtual machines. And I can access the virtual machine. So yesterday I told normally server virtualization things we cannot install by going to server. Okay, we have to access through remotely. So we have a desktop tools. Yesterday I showed one of the desktop tools. It is VMware vSphere client desktop tool. It is see like this. This is support 5.5 and 5.6. Sorry, 5.5 and 5 only. Okay, so you have to give server IP address, username and password, login. So in through my normal desktop, so I can able to access. In another hand, so web browsers also works. Through web browsers, I can able to access my server, and I can create and manage the virtual machines. Okay. This is what we discussed yesterday. Next one is, and also this is a, I told type 1 virtualization, and this is the type 1 virtualization, and also I said it is a bare metal virtualization. It is a bare metal virtualization. So what is the advantage of this virtualization? So we can create a multiple virtual machines in the single machine, we can create a multiple virtual machines. We can install different type of operating systems, depends upon our requirement. And we can install applications, so then we can run virtual machines here. Where is that images? Yeah, here it is. It's a type 1, type 2 virtualization. Okay, that's it. Now, what is this type 2 virtualization? What is this type 2 virtualization? So that's we'll see. I remove this one. So what is it? So what is this type 2 virtualization? Same thing, like I have a machine, and in a machine means we have a resources, and I have an operating system. Okay, I have a operating system. For example, Windows 10. For example, we have a Windows 10 operating system. Example, Windows 10. Okay, and I install an application. I install a application. Here, example of this application from VMware, VMware workstation, or VMware Player. Player is a free version. Workstation is a paid version. Or maybe a from Oracle VirtualBox. VirtualBox. So this is a VMware workstation. You know already. And this is the VirtualBox. It is still now opening mode only. So yeah, here it is. This is a VMware workstation. So you can create any virtual machines, many virtual machines as your requirement. Okay, so I'm going to show you just how many type of operating systems supported by VMware workstation. So just while creating virtual machine, you can see Microsoft Windows, Windows 10, Windows 8, Windows 7, Vista, XP, 2000 Professional, NT, 19 Server, okay, 16 server, 16 server, 9, 12 hyper, not supported. Hyper-V is not supported. 2008, 2003, 2000 server, Windows Millennium, 98, 95, like this. Linux base, these are Linux servers. So different type of Linux, Red Hat Linux, Oracle Linux, OpenSUSE, Mandriva, Fedora, Debian, okay, CentOS, okay, like that. So different type of Linux, of Ubuntu. This is a VMware ESX. You can install VMware ESX 7, 6, 6 point anything, 6, 5, 5.5, like that, 4, you can able to install. You can go to others. If you want to install DOS, you want to practice DOS, Solaris, Novell Netware, FreeBSD, like that. Or it is not a if it is not specified in the what is that particular operating system, okay, like a Windows or Linux or a kind of stuff, it is not specified, also you can use other means that it await other 64 bit operating system. If it is, the model is not specified what kind of operating system it is, edition or a company name, like that's operating system not specified, so you can still, you can install a operating system, right? So this is a type 2 virtualization, because it is a application. To run this application, to install this application and to run this application, we need a operating system. We need a operating system. I have Windows 10 and now I'm installing a Windows 10 only. Next, this is a virtual box. This is a virtual box. This is also an application. To install and run this application, so we need a base operating system is required, and I can able to create a multiple virtual machines. Like if you click on a new, you can see operating system types, Microsoft Windows, Linux, Solaris, BSD, IBM, Mac, or others like that, you can able to. But if I click others, then also it is showing some different type of operating system. Novell Netware, DOS, L4, like that it is showing. Linux based operating system supporting, Windows based operating system supporting, okay, or Solaris, which version you are using, like that it is, which operating system. Okay, so like that we can able to create our virtual machines in using these applications. Okay, you can create a different type of virtual machines, and we can use virtual machines as your physical machines. Like we done a practical in a VMware we install a Windows servers, Linux and Windows 10 also. So what is the advantage of this one? I have a single PC. If I want to take the class, for example, I want to take the class and I want to show you Windows Server and Windows Client. So I have to purchase at least 2 to 3 PCs. How many machines we are using? Like we are using a Windows 10 and we are doing practicals on Windows 10, and we need a Windows Server and then Linux. Till date, we practice on that one. And I took a 2 Linux servers for another purpose, right? So I have to purchase 4 computers or 4 laptops to show you that practical. Otherwise, I have to purchase a 2. So whenever the based on the practicals, like if I am doing on Windows Server, but also I need a Windows Client also required, right? Minimum 2 PCs are required. Again, I have to reformat it. Understand, for example, Windows practicals are completed. Now I need a Linux. Then what I have to do? I format the completely, I remove the operating system in a Windows operating system, I remove from the machine and I have to install the Linux. Okay, and how can I show you how to put a camera on that one? Okay, remote sessions may not work directly. Screen sharing may not work, because if I want to restart my server after installation of some thing in its site, so I have to the remote section will be disconnected automatically. So I have to put a camera in front of thing, right? So like that. Okay, so this is by using an application, I created a different virtual machines and I can able to present and I can able to share. Okay, I can able to run an application. And yesterday also I said DevOps, right? Right. So I install a Windows 10, install a, I create a one virtual machine and put a Windows 10 inside. I install DevOps related all applications. Okay. Git, Jenkins, Maven, or Docker. Last time I installed this one, WebLogic server, Oracle database. Like I install always, you know, I choose to install, I want to put it in a one. So I can able to show you how to installation in a machine and how to work in with one, any issues are there, how to find it. So whatever the things I done in the virtual machine stays in the virtual machine only. Okay. So I can go with the type one virtualization, but I need a server for that one. Again, how to purchase Hyper-V, right? So I have to go to Microsoft Hyper-V, or maybe I have to purchase Proxmox. I don't need to purchase Proxmox. Again, I have to purchase a separate server, and then I have to install either Proxmox, Hyper-V, or a Linux KVM, QEMU. Like that, I have to install, I have to create a virtual machine, then only I can able to present it. But that is not always easy, right? So I have to invest money on extra PC. But instead of that one, in my PC only, in my laptop only, I install a VMware workstation or maybe VMware player or maybe VirtualBox. Older version, it is not working in the new version from Windows 8 onwards. This application won't work. That is called from Microsoft Virtual PC. Okay, if you are using a Windows 7 or a Vista XP, so you can download this virtual PC application and you can create a virtual machine inside. This is also an application only. So if you are using an application and you create a virtual machines in the using that applications, it means that what is that type of virtualization is type 2 virtualization. In type 2 virtualization, you have your own operating system and you install an application, and using this application you are creating virtual machines and we are running the virtual machines. That these virtual machines utilize your hardware resources, but this application runs on your by operating system platform. So your operating system platform is required, of course your hardware also supported for running application, but virtual machines runs on your hardware, application runs on your operating system and hardware, of course. And without this application, we can't run this virtual machine. Without application, we can't run this virtual machine. Okay, so this virtual application provide hypervisor environment for virtual machine. It will virtualize your hardware and it will provide that environment for running virtual machines. So this is a type 2 virtualization. Again, what is the type 1 virtualization? You have your own hypervisor installed in your machine. So this hypervisor is a platform to create a virtual machines in the physical machine. Okay, these virtual machines utilize your hardware and runs on its own. Okay, so it means meaning is it depends upon, it means it utilize your physical resources but not intact with but not contact with your physical resources. It means not binding to your physical resources. You can move the virtual machine from one place to another place. Okay, so this is a type 1 virtualization, bare metal virtualization, no specific operating systems like a Windows operating system or Linux operating system. no specific operating system is not there here. Okay, it is not an application, it is a direct platform installing your hardware. That is called a type 1 virtualization. Type 2 virtualization runs on your machine using an application. You can create a virtual machines and we can run the applications. If I want to run my virtual machines, how to open my VMware workstation or virtual box, then only I can able to run my virtual machines. Okay, I told multiple statements. Guys, understand what is the type 2 virtualization? We need a any of application to create a virtual machine to and run the virtual machine. Guys, understand type 2 virtualization?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Next, what is a type 1 virtualization, type 2 virtualization, server virtualization? So we'll back to the type 2 virtualization, we'll go to the, of course, server virtualization is not completely completed, but I want to tell all the virtualization things. So one by one, like a desktop virtualization. Here, a lot of different statements are there for a desktop virtualization. But in a old test books and in a few places, based on that, I'm telling different statements here is your type 2 virtualization, your type 2. Also, we can say a desktop virtualization. Very simple as per the statement of desktop virtualization means a client can run virtual machines in his desktop. Very simply say, a client create and run different virtual machines in his own desktop. So that is called a desktop virtualization. As per the statement, type 2 virtualization also is a kind of desktop virtualization only. Type 2 virtualization is a desktop virtualization. So what is a type 2 virtualization? You are using an application to create and run virtual machines, to create and run virtual machines in your PC or client PC. Normally client means to differentiate a server model and a client type, so that's where it is. Okay, client PC does not mean it is a Windows client or like that. It is a normal desktop PC. Okay, in his desktop. Okay, in the user desktop. That is called a type 2 virtualization. Also, we can say that is a desktop virtualization also. But desktop virtualization is in a different ways of presenting desktop virtualization is there. Okay. There is a 3 points you should understand in a desktop virtualization. This is the first point. What is the first point is? Type 2 virtualization type means use application, create a virtual machine and run the virtual machines in the your desktop only. So using different applications. What are these applications? Please again tell me what applications we are using directly. VMware workstation. Oracle virtual box, Microsoft
virtual PC.
Okay, here it is player also there, player. Okay, player is a free version, virtual box is a free version, virtual PC is also a free version. Okay, of course, Fusion is there. That is for Mac users. Another VMware Fusion is for a Mac users. Okay, these are applications. Next, the second point, the second one is try to understand the second one. Okay, so I will explain it. So because that is the situation happens based on that only. We are get a direct example situation with this. What happened? So you know XP. Guys knows XP, right? Everybody. XP is an operating system. It is mostly popular operating system like a 95, 98, 2000 and XP. And XP releases into the market, it become a start popular. XP Service Pack 2 is there. It run for a longer bit of time, almost like it is released in 2000, but it is that popular from the Service Pack 2, 2002. Service Pack 2. Okay, XP Service Pack 2 from 2002 onwards, it has become more popular. Of course, we have a less availability that time because of internet and all, not much dollar, but still from 2002 onwards, it is more popular. And almost like a Vista release, like around 2006 or 2007. Okay, so around 6 and 7. Okay, so 6 or 7 Vista release. XP is mostly we are using XP only, minimizer systems. Okay, next one is, so when Vista is not get into the market, so then still XP is using. Even Vista is there, but XP is utilizing. In almost 2009, 9 and 10, so Windows 7 release into the market, so then people are start migrating to the 7 because of hardware availability increases, like a higher RAM capacity, 1 GB, 2 GB RAMs are available, processor P4, dual core to Geo processor there, disk also bigger one. So hardware size is increased into the market, purchasing value of hardware increases, and 7 become popular getting. So XP start reducing. Of course, a operating system for a longer period of time, like a 4 years, 5 years, 6 years, okay, longer period of time, what happened? Lot of hardwares, like your printer, okay, for example, printers, scanners, extra hardwares, scanners, next, system hardware drivers, okay, your motherboard drivers. Different type of motherboards are came into market. Regularly, every year they release a new motherboard, right? And there is a different chipsets are there. Okay, onboard chipsets or maybe adapter cards. So what happened? The company people, means people who build printers, scanners, motherboards, adapters, their drivers, okay, their drivers are created for XP purpose only. Okay, 98 XP, mostly for XP, because they don't have an idea of Vista, Windows 7 that time. So most of the drivers availability, hardware related drivers availability is for XP purpose only. When Windows 7 is released, only new hardware devices having a Windows 7 drivers. But if you are using a old printer or old scanner, a old thing, and but you are using Windows 7, the drivers are not suitable. XP drivers not suitable for Windows 7. Then people get a problem. Okay? Then this is the one kind of problem. What is the second problem? Applications. Another problem is applications. That time, most of the applications are built for 98, 2000, Millennium and XP. And mostly applications are XP purpose only. Those applications also not run in Windows 7 because the application don't understand Windows 7 environment. Windows 7 is a different technique to code, so then automatically application unable to run in a Windows 7 thing. Means compatibility missing. Okay. Got the point? So it is an old application. It is not running. It runs in XP, but it cannot be run in 7 version. Drivers of devices not available for Windows 7 purpose. It is only available for XP purpose only. Understand the situation, guys? 7 and XP. What is the problem we face? Or can I explain it again?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then good. So I have a PC with a Windows 7. So my PC is a Windows 7 PC. It is a Windows 7 PC. Problem is, I purchase a new hardware or maybe a old hardware. I install Windows 7 first of all. Old printers applications are not supporting. So what is this Microsoft people done? They launch XP mode. They launch XP mode for a Windows 7 professional users, not for home users. If you are a Windows 7 Pro and enterprises, Windows 7 Pro or enterprises or ultimate users, Pro, enterprises, business. Okay. So if you are a Windows 7 having so many things are like there, okay. So like a Windows 7 Home Basic, Windows 7 Home, Windows 7 Professional, Enterprise, Business, Ultimate, like different versions are released. So you can download free XP mode in the Windows 7 if you are in this, belongs to this one. Okay. So by support of, it runs based on a supporting, is a virtual PC support. Okay. So what you can able to do is just XP mode is simply look like an application, but when you install that application, automatically XP mode virtual machine will be created. XP mode virtual machine will be created. No space. X, big X, P. Okay, this is a XP mode virtual machine automatically created. So in this virtual machine, XP operating system is there. In this virtual machine, XP operating system is there. So in this one, what are my drivers? Okay, like a printer drivers kind of stuff. And next one is the required applications I installed in this XP mode. I install in the XP mode and I will run my drivers and applications in the XP mode. Got the point? XP mode is nothing but a virtual machine. It is nothing but a virtual machine. So what are the things won't work? Applications or drivers won't run in my Windows 7. I install in my XP mode. Through XP mode, I can able to run my applications and drivers. Understand the point, guys? This part, XP mode. Okay, this is very slowly you should understand. What happened? Can I repeat otherwise? XP mode is a virtual machine. XP mode is a nothing but a virtual machine. Okay. With a XP operating system. With a XP operating system inside. Download XP mode from the internet and double click. It automatically install in your PC and it creates its own XP machine directly. Okay. So in this XP, we can install our applications and we can run the we can like just like you are connected a printer. You have a printer and you are connected a printer. Okay. And now for this printer, it is a wall printer. Drivers are not available for a Windows 7. So I install drivers in XE mode and I can take the print out from the printer. I have a old application which won't work in a XP, sorry, it won't, which won't work in a Windows 7. So I can run this application in XE mode, means in this virtual machine. No one is replying. Okay. So this is an XE mode. It means it's a XE virtual machine.
All these drivers and apps and are compatible with XP version only, sir.
These are compatible with XP only. That's why we are installing here. If it is compatible 7, means directly we can install in a 7. For example, I purchase a new printer. Automatically, new printer contains Windows 7 drivers. So I can install in a Windows 7 only directly. Not required to install here. It's a old one. So, you know.
Yes, sir. If you want to run any application drivers which are compatible with XP version of Windows, so we can install XP mode and run those application drivers.
Yes. That's it.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay.
It's a simple point only. Okay. Good. Good. But one more point is there. Why I'm telling, waiting, because one more point is there, and that you have to imagine. So up to here, you may imagine like a virtual machine Windows 7, a virtual machine in XP virtual machine is there. That up to here, you can able to imagine. Okay, but what is the next one is, you know, it is in an enhanced mode type, okay, or an integrated mode type. So enhanced or integrated, like we can use those words, okay. So it is a kind of enhanced or a integrated mode type. I use this. It means you can't see. You can't see. You can see if you want, but in generally, it is integrated into your Windows 7 only. It is integrated into your Windows 7 only. Means directly, it is look like you are using your Windows 7 only. Like your like this PC only, you can able to see. Okay, it is my Windows 7 only. But when you are running an application, for example. Is any application is a runnable application? Okay, I will take this Eclipse or maybe Java. I'm running this application. Where is this application is located? In my Windows 10 PC only. This application is in my Windows 10 only. When I run this application, it runs in my Windows 7 operating system. On my Windows 7 operating system only, it is in my PC on my Windows 10 PC only it is running, right? This application running, it is showing in my Windows 10 desktop. Okay, it is showing in my Windows 10 desktop. If I open it, it runs in my Windows 10 operating system and system running. Okay, so that is normal. What is this? Is you know, this XE mode won't show on the screen. Like normally, one second. Where is this VMware? It is little bit, like if you see one or two times, you may understand easily. For example, this is my machine. Okay, this is my machine, my Windows 10 machine, of course. This is my DevOps machine. So forget about Windows 10. Don't get confused. Windows 10 means my physical machine. This is a virtual machine. If I run a virtual machine, if I open this virtual machine, And internally, what are the applications are running in this virtual machine? So what I have to do if I want to access this virtual machine? Yeah, it is taking time again. So I have to wait for. Okay, that is my virtual machine, right? If I there is an application in your virtual machine. Okay. It is a little bit okay. So this is my physical machine, and here is my virtual machine. Okay, I have an application in the virtual machine. I have an application in the virtual machine. Now I want to access this virtual application. What I have to do? Turn on the virtual machine, open the virtual machine, log into the virtual machine. And look at this application, run the application. How it is look like? Your application is running in this virtual machine only, right? Normally. Get the point? This application running in this virtual machine only. So whatever you see, it is running here only. You don't feel like a physical machine, virtual machine, something confusion is not there. Very simple. You open a machine, you're running an application, it runs in your virtual machine only, and you can see it is running in your virtual machine only. So without any confusion, with full clarity, we can able to see. But point is, in the XP mode, this is my Windows 7, and I have a XP mode running in a background. It won't show on the screen. You can see if you want it. But generally, it is runs in a background. There is an application XP mode. There is an application XP mode. Actually, I done in a practical manner. But okay, for example, in a XP mode, I have a Office 2003 is there. In a XP mode, I installed Office 2003. In Windows 7, I installed Office 2007. Got the point? In Windows 7, 2007 Office is there. In XP mode, 2003 Office is there. Okay. Now I click on a start menu like this. I click on a start menu and I want to open Office. I scroll down and find out where is the Office. It shows both options. It shows Office 2003. And as well as Office 2007 also. If I open 2003 Word, okay, 2003 Office Word I open. Where is this application is located? In XP mode virtual machine. Application is in XP mode virtual machine. But where I open? In Windows 7. I run, it is look like you're running in the Windows 7 only. You are running in a Windows 7 only. But actually it is running in a your virtual machine, XP only. That is called enhancing. It means it is integrated. These applications and drivers in the XP mode is integrated with your Windows 7. So you can operate those applications and drivers directly from Windows 7. Okay, it is look like you are operating from Windows 7 directly. Yeah, tell me now.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yeah.
Sir, this XP mode is continuously running in the physical machine, sir.
Yes.
So won't that reduce the performance of the physical machine?
Yes.
As you said, we are directly accessing Office 2003 from Windows 7. That means that the XP mode is continuously running.
It is running. Correct. So automatically the machine is running. If I open a virtual machine here, automatically it is, if I don't shut down after usage, what happened? My physical resources are consumes. Correct. Correct one. Continuously it is running means consumes a thing. So you have to check. So the RAM and all 2 GB, 3 GB RAM. Okay. But normally XP will consume very less. 128 MB RAM, 256 MB RAM maximum. But if you have a 2 GB RAM, you don't feel that much of slow. You don't feel that much of slow in generally. For example, you have 2 GB RAM, then XP consumes very less, and into XP mode it consumes very very less. So even if your XP mode is continuously running, so you don't feel your Windows 7 becomes slow. Got the point? One point. But your question is very important. Not trash your answer question. So you're important. One is very good question. XP mode continuously running. So obviously Windows 7 becomes slow. You make sure that you should have a good RAM. And make sure it should not consume more. That's it. So that is one point. But thing is, of course, you can shut down your XP mode also. Like if you no longer required, you are not using next time, you are maybe, you can go to the start menu, you can find XP mode directly, option is there. You can turn off XP mode if you are not using applications or drivers from the XP mode. You are not utilizing your XP applications, then you can turn off it. If in case there is a major thing you have to run in your Windows 7, whatever the XP consuming, whether it is 128 MB RAM or 256 MB RAM or 512 MB RAM, whatever it is RAM consuming, but major applications running in Windows 7 and you are not utilizing any XP mode applications in your Windows 7, then what to do? Shut down the XP mode. Okay, so there is a 2 points. Very good. And importantly, you understand something is what, how it is working. Okay, so for example, I open a machine, it is a 6 GB machine, not required. What to do? Shut down the virtual machine. If I open my Windows Linux PC, it is a 1 GB RAM, or maybe XP machine, it will take very less, like you can see. This is 512 MB RAM. If I'm running this one, it not much effect on my physical resources, not much. 512 is a general, very less, because I have a very good RAM availability. So I can run this virtual machine directly, no problem. But if I run this one 6 GB machine, it's definitely effective. Okay, so that's the difference. I'm not audible. Again, what happened to audio? Not audible. One second, I will check the settings. Okay, here it is showing device is connected. It is showing device is connected. Yeah, speaker is working, microphone, it is showing it is green colors here. Okay, yeah, got it. Am I audible now? It looks like everything is fine. What to do? Someone is crying very loudly. जगन। हाँ हाँ అది తెలియట్లేదు, ఇది ఇక్కడ గ్రీ అన్ని కరెక్ట్ గానే ఉన్నట్టు చూపిస్తుంది. అదే ఇది లేదంటే ఇది ఫినిష్ చేస్తే లంచ్ బ్రేక్ తీసుకుందాం చూస్తున్నాను. ఇప్పుడు వస్తుందా? నేను బ్లూటూత్ నుంచి మామూలుగా పెట్టేశాను, మామూలు మైక్లో పెట్టాను. వినిపిస్తుందా అప్పుడు? ఓకే ఓకే వీ విల్ టేక్ లంచ్ బ్రేక్. జస్ట్ లెట్ మీ ఫినిష్ దట్ స్మాల్ థింగ్. ఐ చేంజ్ మై బ్లూటూత్ టు మైక్రోఫోన్. Okay, just let me finish this part. Where is this? Where are we? Yeah, you are, well, guys, you asked question, right? So it continuously runs means it consumes thing. Okay, if you are not required, then you can shut down it also. That is also possibility there. That is your XVMO. Understand the integration of XVMO to Windows 7. Now it is not there, of course. This is the second type, second like a explanation of desktop virtualization. There is a third one is also there, okay? But understand what is the second type of desktop virtualization is. So example is XVMod. Example is XVMod. In Windows 7 is another example of understanding of this one. It means simple understanding is if you are integrate your virtual machine applications to your physical machine, so then you can operate run application from your physical machine, but actually it is operating your virtual machine. Okay, we can integrate like that. This is also given in desktop virtualization list. Okay. So there is a third one is there. So just I will introduce third one and we'll take a lunch break. Okay. What is the third one? Is a VDI infrastructures. Is a one of the thing. Okay. It means again there is a separate server. Like when server virtualization hypervisor, that time I told VMware workstation, VMware player, sorry. VMware vSphere and VMware ESXi, Citrix Zen Server, Microsoft Hyper-V, Proxmox for a server virtualization. I given a list of examples, server virtualization, hypervisor related one, right? In a desktop virtualization also, we have a to make a desktop as a virtualization kind of stuff. Desktop virtualization is not a lone one. It is combination of user state virtualization. Okay, it is a combination which is combinedly like a UE, okay, user experience virtualization or a user state virtualization kind of stuff will okay. You have to combine what desktop virtualization, user state virtualization to make as a single desktop virtualization is possible if you are combining together. Okay. So what is VDI, virtual desktop environment or infrastructure is there? Not environment, it is infrastructure. Virtual desktop infrastructure is a VDI infrastructure is also there. Okay. Desktop virtualization for understanding, lot of deep points are there. Practically, I can't show you these things. One we understand is type 2, that is we know. But XVMod is required. Again, we need a Windows 7. We have to install it. Again, we have to download an XVMod. Earlier, I have a packages are there, but it will take time to do all these things. One, but understanding XVMod is important. That's for understanding. VDI infrastructure, afternoon I will tell you what is a remote desktop, what is a desktop virtualization, remote apps access, this kind of stuff, and we'll go to the application virtualization. Then we'll see storage and networking virtualization also. Okay, for storage and networking virtualization, so I'll show you Hyper-V, how to install Hyper-V. We'll see in afternoon. Now you take your lunch break, come back at, when we'll be back? Start logging at 2:30. I will start 2:45. If in case any late, my lunch late, or guys, you are not joining by 2:45, everyone. If you join everyone, then I will start by 2:45 only. Any late, maximum 3 o'clock. Anyway, right? It's already 1:30, so take a lunch break. Come back fast. Okay?